Good morning.
Honorable Justice Pratibha Singh, Dr. Agarwal, and all the other distinguished guests on the podium.
It's my pleasure being here and addressing this conference.
Chairman.
I have the proud privilege of assisting Dr. Agarwal as a knowledge partner in the GIPC event since the time it started in 2009. I'm glad to see it has grown in size and in depth over all these years. The theme of today's workshop or conference is disruptive technology. Disruption does not mean destruction. Disruption, if we embrace disruption and move on and evolve with the disruption and taking advantage of the disruption, we can all progress. In fact, there's no choice. It's going to happen. That's nature. It's going to happen. It's in our best interest to embrace the disruption and take maximum advantage of it. A small anecdote to a story that I can relate. My firm has about, close to 100 lawyers. And my firm is broadly divided into chemical attorneys, attorneys practicing chemical technologies, and those that practice in electrical and computer science technologies. Because of my unique background, I have an undergraduate in chemical engineering and graduate studies in computer science. I was in both departments. And assigned to both departments. 25 years back, when I joined my firm, Fuji was an important chemical client. So we would see stacks of files on the chemical department side with the title Fuji on it. And there were like maybe one or so on the electrical computer science side. Today is the other way around. Today, Fuji is still one of the largest clients of the firm, but the electrical stack is this big and the chemical is hardly anything. What happened? Photography as a technology was a chemical technology 25 years back. And through the last 10, 20 years, it's become almost 100% electrical software technology. Today, there's still some printing. There are people who print photographs and you need some chemical processing. But everything is pretty much electrical and software. So Fuji is a company that adapted the disruption and evolved with it, and they prospered because of the disruption. On the other hand, Fuji's company 25 years back was Kodak. Kodak did not follow that approach. And today Kodak is not in existence, unfortunately. So disruption, adopted in a positive way, will actually prosper, and we can all, as a nation, prosper. 25 years back, our girls and boys took to Y2K, that was a disruptive technology, and we prospered, and we grew our software, and we became a powerhouse in the software technology. Today it's AI, and fortunately, my academic background, my master's was in AI 25 years back, and I worked in the field. AI is no magic. The intelligence can be put into a system after a significant amount of knowledge base has been developed. So there is a significant amount of work that needs to be done. We have to, categorize systems, we have to name them, all the ontologies have to be developed, all the epistemologies have to be developed. So there's a significant amount of groundwork that needs to be done. And this is the type of technology for which you don't need sophisticated laboratories and stuff like that. A boy or a girl sitting with a small computer in a small town, can assist in the process. So it's ideally suited for us, for our country. We have a significant number of people who have the software mathematics. Computer programming type background, so we can sit back
And wherever we are, without need for sophisticated technologies, we can develop the background that is necessary for AI systems to develop. Okay? So this theme of this conference is appropriate, and it helps us, and I hope to meet as many of you as possible over the next couple of 3 years, and I thank Dr. Agarwal for keeping me associated with this conference.